Henrietta Lacks was an African-American woman who lived in the Baltimore region. She contracted cervical cancer and was receiving treatment at Johns Hopkins for that cancer. And in the process of her treatment, the doctors removed some of the cells from her tumor. They were interested at the time in growing cells in a lab and trying to get cells to grow for longer than just a few weeks, which is a typical length of time. What was important from Henrietta's perspective is that the doctors didn't get consent from her to remove the cells and to kind of keep them and grow them. And she later died within a matter of a few months. She died because of the cervical cancer, but her cells actually continued to live on in the lab. And unlike most cells that they studied, these cells were able to divide and divide and divide again. And so they achieved what is informally called immortality, meaning that you can keep them alive indefinitely. And that's why we're able to still have the cells in the exhibit today. But even for decades afterward, members of her family were not aware that Henrietta's cells were still alive over at Johns Hopkins. HeLa cells, which is what the cells are now called. These cells were used by medical researchers to develop the polio vaccine. They were used in studying HIV and obviously cancer and various other kinds of medical research because the cells are easy to grow. They grow very readily, they divide, and they're very consistent over time. They've also even been taken into space, I believe, on one of the space shuttle missions. They were actually used in experiments conducted there. Really, including this exhibit in Cells to Self, what we really were interested in is the fact that not only are these cancer cells that you're looking at, but they are cells that speak to questions of medical ethics and also questions of identity. In other words, the cells have been removed from Henrietta Lacks' body in 1951, and they have still continued living all the way to today and will continue on. And so how does that speak to whether the cells belong to her or are still a part of her, and how are they not a part of her? And so it really gets at questions of cells and self. The Exploratorium has been growing HeLa cells on and off for the last 10 years. And in particular, in the lab, what we have to do is every now and then take a vial of the cells from the freezer where they're stored and grow them in a tissue culture dish where they're able to kind of grow and divide, and then we can actually save some of those cells and freeze them and then thaw them again later. So in other words, we can achieve a fresh culture over time for the exhibit and keep the exhibit running. What's unique at the Exploratorium is that we're able to present live cells and to keep them alive in a museum setting, which is not the easiest thing to do, but it's something that we've managed to do over the years. And it's really interesting for people to have heard the story of HeLa cells and of Henrietta Lacks to be able to come here and see the cells firsthand. And actually, we've had a couple of visits from members of the Lacks family who have come to the Exploratorium. Various members of the family have come to see the cells in the exhibit and in the lab, and that's also a really interesting thing for them, because while they've seen them before, it's not a common occurrence even for them, even though they have a very personal family connection to the cells and to Henrietta.